Good morning, all of you. Today we will learn direct and indirect speech. Direct or quoted speech is a sentence that reports speech or thought in its original form, as phrased by the original speaker. It is usually enclosed in quotation marks. Indirect speech, also called reported speech, is a sentence that reports speech or thought without quoting the exact words. For example, John said, "I am very busy now." You can see "I am very busy now" is in quotations. So it is direct speech. We will change it into indirect without changing the meaning, but we will change its form. John said that he was very busy then. Here we can see one example of direct and indirect speech. In the first case, it is written, the teacher said, please keep the noise down. Here, please keep the noise down is in quotations. So it is direct speech. Here in this case, the verb said is used. It is known as reporting verb. While the thing in quotations is reported speech. So, in indirect speech, it will be the teacher told us to keep the noise down. Here, simple present will be changed into simple past. We use simple present, first form of the verb, and in indirect speech, we use simple past, second form of the verb. For example, she said, I live in Delhi. It will be in indirect speech, she said that she lived in Delhi. Number two, he said, I live in Delhi. He said that he lived in Delhi. I said, I live in Delhi. I said that I lived in Delhi. You said, I live in Delhi. You said that you lived in Delhi. If the reported speech has a universal truth or habitual fact, then there will be no change in tenses. Our teacher said the sun rises in the east. That will be as it is. Our teacher said that the sun rises in the east. Next one. Anu said to me, I write with my left hand. Means it is a habitual fact. Anu told me, said to will be changed into told. If said is followed by a preposition like to, it will be changed into told. So, Anu told me that she writes with her left hand. Another example of a universal truth. Adit said, there are countless stars in the sky. This is true. We can't change it. It will be like this. Adit said that there are countless stars in the sky. Now, there are some rules of tenses. If you have been given the direct speech in simple present, it will be converted to simple past. For example, she always wears a coat. He said that she always wore a coat. Present continuous will be changed into past continuous. I am looking for my keys. She said that she was looking for her keys. Present perfect, it will be changed into past perfect. She has written three letters for her friend. He said that she had written three letters for her friend. Simple past will be changed into past perfect. For example, my friend gave me a bar of chocolate. He said that his friend had given him a bar of chocolate. Will be changed into would. I will finish my report in 2 days. He said that he would finish his report in 2 days. Other than that, can will be changed into could. May will be changed into might, etc. Now, for changing interrogative sentence into indirect speech, we have to observe the nature of question and then change it into indirect speech according to its rules for indirect speech. A question can be of two types. One type, which can be answered in only yes or no. And the other type, which needs a little bit explanation for its answer and cannot be answered in only yes or no. The questions that can be answered with yes or no, there we have to use if or whether. For example, she said to me, "Are you unwell?" She asked me if I was unwell. I said to him, "Were you present at the meeting yesterday?" I asked him whether he had been present at the meeting the day before. The woman said to the stranger, "Should I help you?" The woman asked the stranger whether she should help him. The next questions are where we can't use yes or no, or where we can't answer with yes or no. I said to him, "Who are you?" I asked him who he was. The mother said to the daughter, "Do you know where Ali is?" The mother asked the daughter whether she knew where Ali was. This is the yes no question. Okay. Next one. The judge said to the lawyer, "Have you anything to say on behalf of the accused?" This is also yes no question. The judge asked the lawyer if he had anything to say on behalf of the accused. Next, the wolf said to the lambs, "Why are you all so sad?" The wolf asked the lambs why they were all so sad.